This is Dave Franklin, broadcasting from Wheaton College. High school, Hopkinton High School swim and dive team against Mansfield. Unusual meet this year. This time we're starting with diving. Typically, diving is sort of in the first third of the meet. So the officials giving the divers some instructions. So they just announced the order of diving. This is Leah Toronto. Looks like there was some confusion on the dive. Her older sister, senior. This is Allie. Similar colors on the suits. But this is a Mansfield diver. This is Brianna. So Lissy Annenberg. threesome. Extremely respectable eight and a half on that. Here comes Aaron. Aaron's a senior, but he will be diving here next year for Wheaton College. Jack. Huckington has a fairly young girls diving team this year. The five divers here competing tonight. Only one is a senior. Of course, the girls' diving team was the best dive team in the state last year. The girls, Maddie, Alyssa, and Renee, have the top three diving scores in school history. As we're looking at Reese. Yeah. 6.5 and 8.5. A lot of air between those numbers. Reese, of course, has destroyed the school record last year. Aaron Howe, number 3 on the all-time diving list. A lot of these freshmen, it's tough to get up there. Your everybody's looking at you, it's dead quiet. Air between those numbers too. Every now and then you see a dive. Somebody comes pretty close to that board. Good scores, 7 and 7.5. Here with the difficulties. 7.5 and 8.5 for Reese. Beautiful. Nice. She had good rotation on that. Some good height on that one. Okay. gets an average of four. Jack gets an average of four on Hamilton. I think we're up to dive five, I think. Sixes for Lissy. Two 2.4 degree of difficulty coming up here for Reese. For the classic inward pike position. Pair of six and a halfs. Straight reverse dive. Final round. Here comes Leah. Thank you. Mizzy's final dive. 1.8 degree of difficulty. Allie going for a 2.3 here. Be a lot of motion.
Nice.
Somersault, one twist. A lot of these divers, they start out as freshmen, hitting threes, fours, and fives. And Coach Brainerd gets them in some pretty amazing shape, has them do some pretty amazing stuff. And by the time they're seniors, they are really a sight to watch. It's a 2.3 from Melissa. There are sevens for Reese. A number of moms in the audience were cringing and looking away at that moment. These athletes work within pretty close precision, though. Nice one, Aaron. I don't know that I've seen that dive from him yet this year. Jack on the board for his last dive. Well, we will take a couple minute break and catch the swimming. Okay, and we're here. The 200 medley relay is beginning. Hopkinton lanes 1, 3, 5, and 7. Got Sarah Kang in lane 1, Logan Salyards, Olivia Handerhan in 3, Abby Fisher in 5, Logan Salyards in 7. And out to a lead is team in lane five. This is Emily Way. Second place is Tiana McCann in lane three. In for the fly is Rachel Zale. And lane three, Julia Pilarella. It's going to be a tight race for third. Touch. It's Grace Kavanaugh. I don't know if we're looking for a qualifying time here. Maybe school record. Not sure. We'll have to see. I've got a couple of unofficial timers. And we've definitely got a race there for second place. Here comes Grace Kavanaugh. Unofficial time of 2:01. Or 201. And Hoppington picks up third, so that's 10 points for the Hillers. Emily Schmidt finishing up. B relay team. We've got Mercedes finishing in lane one, and then over far across the pool in lane seven, Megan Halloran. So that was about a 2:01. It's definitely a state qualifying time for that team. Congratulations to the girls. The school record on the girls' side for that is 155. Set in 2014. February of 2014. I think that would probably be at States. So we see the boys getting ready. Here in lane three, we've got Colin Thine. In lane five, Young Jun Kim. And in lane seven, Jack Brennan. Mansfield off to a good start. Mansfield with the clear lead. Lane five, we've got. All right, folks, sorry. We had a dead battery here. We have a fight for third. It looks like Hoppington may have out-touched. That was our diver, Aaron Howe, in lane three.
we out touched him, right? That was Aaron. That was Aaron.
All right, sorry about that, folks. Got 3.5 hours left on the battery now. If we're still here in that time, something's wrong. All right. Now we're preparing for the girls' 200 freestyle. Down here in lane one, we've got Mallory. In lane three, Lydia. Lane five, Bridget. And lane seven is Julia. It is a full house here tonight. I see some alum here. Some super fans over there. It's Green Man and Orange Man. Don't see them out too often. Freestyle is off. Okay, we're pretty close. We got Franklin and Belger in 3 and 5. Right up there with the Mansfield swimmer. Lydia Franklin picking up a little bit of room. The race now halfway over. We'll have to see if Bridget can catch and pull in a second place. Still with a decent lead. I think Lydia Franklin going for some time here. She hits at an unofficial 209. Unofficial 209. Richard Belger in third. Huffington takes fourth. Julia Gorgel and fifth. I think you can only score 3 swimmers. Mm-hmm. lead in the water. Coming up for the boys, we will have Ray Lucas in lane one. At Brad Canty in three. Austin Schofield in five. And Zachary Holbrow in lane seven. Mansfield swimmer. Very comfortable lead, but we've got three hillers right behind him. Looks like it's going to be an easy win for the Mansfield swimmer. No, sorry. He's took another 50 to go. But we've got Brad Canty catching up to Austin. Oh, Austin, gotta go. Oh, Coach King is not happy. Honestly, I thought it was the 200 to before, so. Zach, you got Austin. They came in at about a 222. Unofficial. And then lane one, Ray Lucas. The girls, I am. Lane one would be Caitlin Salyards. Lane three, Tiana McCann. Lane five, Emily Way. And lane seven, Kaylee Cahane. And as with all pools, lane one is on the right as you are standing on the blocks. Close race. Nice backstroke there by Emily. Make the turn for the final, the breaststroke. By Mansfield in lane four. And in third place is Tiana McKinn. Mansfield's pouring it on. Wow. All right. That was close. That was about a 2:23 unofficial. Tiana, good job for third place. And now for fourth, looks like it's going to be Kaylee in lane seven. Boys I Am, we've got, again, closest to the bottom of the screen, we've got, Jack Brennan, Sam Richardson is in three, Sean Kelly is in five, and Sam Cody in seven. By the way, for the girls, that unofficially was likely a qualifying time for sectionals. 200 IM sectional qualifiers at 229.89. States is a 222.76. So without the official times here, we can only make conjectures, but they seem to be in the ballpark. Mansfield boys again seem to have a leader. But Hopkinton's got some decent depth. Sophomore Sam Richardson in three. Senior Sean Kelly in five. Currently second and third. We have Sam Cody there in the far lane, lane seven. Trying for a fourth place. Gets a nice push off the wall. So turn back to the leader from Mansfield. Clear lead. Sam Richardson in lane three. Unofficial time of a 2:22. And you got Sean Kelly. For third, and Sam Cody picks up fifth place, scoring a point for the Hillers. As we see the girls on deck for the 50 freestyle. In the 50, you'll have Emily Schmidt in lane one, Rachel Zale in lane three, Grace Kavanaugh in lane five, Olivia Hendrahan in lane seven. This is gonna be a fast heat, people. Sectional qualifier time is at 26.99, and state qualifier is at 26.07. Like Hopkinton may go 1-2-3. You got Grace Kavanaugh touching first, Olivia, Rachel. Hopkinton goes 1-3-4. Unofficial time 25-71. unofficial for Grace. Yes, that's an unofficial time. The school record in 50 free is a 25.68. A second heat here. Caitlin O'Connor in lane one, Ashley Person in lane three, Julia Altman in lane five, Maggie Miller in seven. Got Caitlin O'Connor with a nice start in lane one. Strong swimmers on this team. About a 30.5 unofficial. Boys 50 free, we have Ian Holmes in lane one, Jake Glover in lane three, Paul Richardson in five, and Aaron Howe in seven. Boys, a sectional qualifier would be a 23.88. Good turn there in lane five from Paul. Paul touches. Jake about unofficially a 26.17. Paul unofficially 24.42. This is normally in the time of the meet where they'd have the diving, followed by a warm up. So right now they'll just have the warm up, and we'll be back in a few minutes. Okay, we're here at 100 fly. Sarah in lane one, Rachel in three, Tiana in five, and Logan in seven. Pretty close race right now. Hopkinton gets two, possibly three. Unofficial time, 1:10. That was Rachel. About 1:10. The boys coming up. We have Connor Murchie in lane one, Trevor Perkins in three, Sean Kelly in five, and Young Jun Kim in lane seven. We've got four butterflies here. It looks like Mansfield may only have two. Start for Mansfield. We got Sean and Young Jun first to touch at the wall for Hopkinton. It'll be an easy second, third. Not easy. Second, third for Hopkinton. Unofficial time, 1:07. Nothing easy about that stroke. All right. We have the girls' 100 freestyle. Heat one, we'll have Emily Schmidt in lane one, Lydia Franklin in lane three, Bridget Belger in lane five, Olivia Handerham in lane seven.
Three and Bridget Belger.
be a good race as well. Mansfield touches first, but you have Franklin, Handerhan, and Belger right on her tail. Down. It's going to require some pretty big effort from Hopkinton to catch his Mansfield swimmer. Mansfield's looking pretty good though. And time. Franklin, Handerhan, and broke a minute, unofficially 59.97.
That's a qualifying time.
Did you time it?
Second heat of the girls. We've got Kelly Burke in lane one, Ashley Person in three, Kylie Salyards in five, and Julia Allman in seven. The 100 freestyle qualifying time for states. For states is for sectionals a 59.25. For states is a 57.67. So. It all depends on the official time. Kelly Burke with a 106 unofficial. Followed closely by Kylie, Julia, and then Ashley. Now we come to the boys' 100 freestyle. Lane one is Shane Horseman, lane three, Austin Schofield, lane five, Paul Richardson, and in lane seven is Ray Lucas. Qualifier times for the boys are pretty fast. And at freestyle, it's in the 52s. Austin and Paul Massari the pool. Austin and Paul off to a good start. Six at the turn, 27. Glides in to 56-2. Austin with about a one flat unofficial. Taking fourth and fifth, Ray and Shane. Now we've got the 500 freestyle coming up. Stephanie Kapelos in one, Julia Gorgel in three, Abby Fisher in five, Sierra Schlussel in seven. Important job. Lap counters. Fisher there in the lead. Got a 105 an official on the split. Julia catching, making up some time here. flirting with a third place there. About a 1:14 for her time. Been in seven. We've got Sierra. Unfortunately, obscured by the crowd in lane one, Stephanie. This is where the lap counting comes in. Important. The officials do keep track of everybody's laps, of course. It's about a 2:16. For the girls, the qualifying time for sectionals is 5:58, and states is a 5:49. The school record set by Megan Farrell, 5:05.3. That record is likely to stand for a few more years at least. Julia's got a good grasp of third place there. That's excellent. Maybe Fisher on 15 lengths. Appears likely she is going to lap the second place swimmer. Julia Gorgel can keep this up. She may nab second. She's looking pretty strong. Example of how incredible a swimmer of Megan Farrell was. As we're looking at here, Abby Fisher, probably one of the better swimmers we've got on the team now, or have seen. Of course, we've got a strong team. But Abby Fisher cruising here, make it look effortless. And 5:43, that is a state qualifier. Julia Gorgel nearly caught second, but she got another 40 to go. Julia with a 6.34. Hockenkamp takes 1-3. Mansfield second and fourth. And fifth. So good job by Stephanie, outpacing the Mansfield swimmer to pick up that fifth and final scoring position for Hoffington. And we've got Sierra finishing up here in lane seven. Mansfield swimmer comes in lane eight. Now we prepare for the boys, 500 freestyle. For us, lane one is empty. Lane three will be Zach Hulbrow. Lane five is Sam Richardson. And lane seven is Brad Canty. Super fans. It's a long meet here. Double dual meets. And the boys are up. From bottom of the screen to top, we've got Zach in three, Sam in five, Brad in seven. Thank you. So that's Sam Richardson in lane five. Right on the heels. Mansfield swimmer. For Sam, the new swimmer on the team. And a sophomore. And then heading by for his 10th length. In lane three, that's Zach. And on the far side of the pool is Brad in lane seven. Confusion on the lap counter there. I don't think this. You know what? That's a little tricky too. Those numbers don't flip the way you think they're going to flip. Zach making his turn, 51st length, sorry, that would be 13th, 15th, 15th. Bell lap for Mansfield. And 50 to go for Sam. Oh, big kick there by Mansfield swimmer. Wow. Sam Richardson, first Hopkinton finisher. Second place, that's 4 points for the team. He swam unofficial 6:12. Got Zach coming in for third. Followed closely by Brad. Hopkinton takes 2-3-4. Based on the point scores, 6-4-3-2-1. If you manage to get second, third, and fourth, you actually end up ahead. 9 points, and the team that gets first and fifth gets 7 points. So you can actually win a meet without winning any single individual events. Well, that's rare. A few laps to go for the Mansfield swimmers. Coming up next is the 200 freestyle relay. Coach King likes to mix things up, create different relay configurations. Last meet, we didn't catch it on HCAM here, but the 200 freestyle relay girls team set a school record. And I see here different configurations. So I think he likes to try out different combinations of swimmers, potentially get a couple of options for state qualifiers to keep his options open for staffing the three relays at states. And it depends, too, on how many individual events each swimmer may qualify for. Swim lane. Lane one is open for the girls.
Records,
oh, no, we do have a lane one. Oh, yeah, sorry. Maggie Miller, lead off in lane one. Kaylee, lead off in three. Rachel, leading off in lane five. And Caitlin, leading off in lane seven. So we've got in lane in the centers of the pool, the center two lanes. We've got Keohane, Schmidt, Kang, and Peshoff in lane five. They've got Zael, Belger, Franklin, and Wei. Then on the far side, O'Connor, Burke, Halloran, Salyards, and on the near side, Miller, Salyards, Lahai. Sorry if I'm not pronouncing that right. And Yanawai. Yeah, the other thing we missed with the HCAM was the All Salyards 500. Another thing Coach King likes to do. Some clever combinations. There was a double date relay one year. I think we had the All Emily relay last year. All right, this is going to get noisy. Lane five, out to a lead, Zael. In the midst of the Mansfield swimmers, we've got Keohane and O'Connor. Zael off to Belger. Schmidt in lane three. Schmidt is picking up some ground on Mansfield's A-team. Had a good turn. Got Franklin waiting in lane five. Schmidt has given the B-team a lead over the Mansfield A. Some good kicking there. Franklin coming in, touching for Emily Wei. Sarah Kang in three, handing off to Mallory. Emily Wei. About a 150. Lane three, our B team is coming in at about a 202. Hopkinton takes first and third.
course, he's going to have many different combinations of that relay. So.
And he'll decide.
Because I remember freshman year.
Yeah,
let's
qualify 1 year. She didn't get to go.
Yes, and to have a special freshman year.
He takes the seniors.
All right, we've got the boys coming up. The boys, 200 freestyle relay. We've got three teams in here. This is good. We got a sizable boys team this year. So good to see us fielding a few teams. So in lane one is open. Lane three, Sam Cody leading off. In lane five, Paul Richardson. In lane seven, Justin Buffard. In three, it will be Cody, Holbrow, Howe, and Lucas. In lane five, it'll be Richardson, Kelly, Schofield, and Glover. And in seven, it'll be Buffard, Horseman, Holmes, and Murchie. I have no idea the score, but it seems like the Hillers probably enjoying a lead on both sides. Five, Paul Richardson, also a new swimmer on the team. Actually, all three of the Hopkinton swimmers are new to the team this year, although Paul is a senior. Well, that's a pretty good start. Sean Kelly in lane five, making the turn. You've got Shane and Zach making the turns, fighting for second and third place. Here comes Austin. Nice entry. It's going to be close for second place. We've got Aaron Howe in three, Ian Holmes in seven. Austin coming in for the handoff to Jake. Okay, Aaron Howe bringing it in for second place, handing off to Ray Lucas and Connor Murchie in lane seven. And here comes Jake Glover. You hear the cowbells of the Glover fan club. And Jake takes first for the Hillers. Second place. And you can only score two relays per team. So Ray Lucas finishing up second place for the Hillers. Connor Murchie finishing up in lane seven. Now we're on to the backstroke, 100 backstroke for the girls. We'll have Amanda Mack in lane one, Julia Pillarella in lane three, Grace Kavanaugh in five, Logan Salyards in seven. That was about a 144 unofficial for the boys. Testament to the strength of the girls' team this year. We're talking about state and sectional qualifiers and school records already. It's only the second week into the season. Well, I guess it's the third week at this point. But watch Grace in lane five. Another freshman on the team, Grace Kavanaugh. We got Julia in three. And in seven, it's Logan. About a 105, that looks to be a sectional qualifier. About a 112 and a 114. 1-2-3 for the Hillers is a sweep. And Amanda Mack in lane one. Coming up for the boys, it's going to be Jack Brennan in lane one, Trevor Perkins in three, Young Jun Kim in five, Colin Thine in seven. Colin Thine in lane seven will be, I believe, the third such family swimmer for the Hillers. The fourth? No, I think just the third. Mansfield Swim with an early lead. Hopkinton fighting back though, currently with second, third, and fourth. And June, you're looking pretty strong. Thank you. like the Hillers will take second, third, and fourth. As Trevor Collin. And coming down at the bottom of your screen in lane one. Ah, you can't even see him. Jack Brennan. There you go. All right. Down to the last two events. 100 breaststroke. And following that, the 400 freestyle relay. For Hopkinton on the breast, for the girls' side, it's Maggie Miller in lane one, Kaylee Keohane in three, Emily Way in five, and Caitlin O'Connor in seven. Kaylee makes the turn. Then Caitlin and Maggie in lane one. And we go back to find Emily. Last turn. Sizable lead. Looks like a solid second and third for Mansfield, but we've got Emily Way. Very comfortable lead. It's about a 119. A 119 is very close to sectional time, so it really depends on what the official time is. But again, we're still pretty early in the season. We haven't even tapered. So I expect to see a lot of fast times for this team in the coming weeks. And up for the boys now on the 100-yard breaststroke in lane one, Justin Bouffard in lane three, Jacob Glover in lane five, Sam Cody. Lane seven, Shane Horseman. Hopkinton superfans. Actually, I guess they're just Jake superfans. They brought cowbells, they brought signs. There's the scorer's table. Jake and Sam neck and neck right there. Well, I see the official with his arm up. Looks like a bad stroke. He may have a disqualification somewhere. Cody with the second place, Jake with third. And in fourth place, Justin. Shane coming in. Good finish for the Hillers. They're going to talk about disqualification, perhaps. Perhaps they're switching for the relay, switching positions. Relay. The girls relay in lane one. We've got Stephanie on the block. Tiana in three, Bridget in five, Mallory in seven. Could have been a Mansfield disqualification. I saw the official over on that side. So in the center of the pool in three, we've got McCann, Salyards, Schmidt, Handrahan. In five, we've got Belger, Kavanaugh, Franklin, Fisher. Lane seven at the far end, Peshoff, Gorgel, Salyards, and Kang. And in lane one, Kapilos, Yenawine, Halloran, and Mack. School record here is an impressive 3:45. Qualifying time here is a 4:05 for stakes. Belger after a good start. About a 29 on the turn. About a 31 for McCann. Belger hands off to Kavanaugh. McCann off to Salyards. In lane seven, we've got Julia Gorgel on the water. And in lane one now, Leah Genewine. Today's A team, Grace Kavanaugh. And today's B team, and Coach King. always shaking things up, trying different configurations. Kavanaugh coming in for the Hillers. Franklin on the block. We're at about a 159. B team is in the water. That's Schmidt. Franklin on the turn, 228. Third leg, Franklin handing off to Abigail Fisher. For the Hillers, out about a 3 minutes. Fisher heading out, Schmidt coming in. Olivia Handrahan, lane three. In lane seven, we see Peyton Salyards. Sarah Kang in the water now for the Hillers. And Abby Fisher in the lead on two lengths over the Mansfield swimmer. Andrahan, solid second place. And we have about a four flat on today's 18. With Handrahan coming in for second place. That's about a 4:21. Hillers pick up 12 points for those relays. Final swimmers in for the Mansfield team. Lane two and lane eight. On the boys' side now, we have in lane three, Zach Holbrow. In lane five, we have Sam Richardson. And in lane seven, we have Ray Lucas. In lane three, it's Holbrow, Kim, Perkins, and Thine. In lane five, it will be Richardson, Kelly, Schofield, and Canty. And in lane seven, it will be Lucas, Murchie, Holmes, and Brennan. That team in lane seven, an all-freshman relay team. Final event of the evening. About a 27 on the turn for Richardson, about 32 for Hallbrow and Lucas. About a 56 unofficial for Sam Richardson. Mansfield right up there with us. John Kelly makes the turn. Mansfield is catching up. After Kelly, we've got Schofield. On the block, the Mansfield kid is the one who won the fly. He's fast. Excellent line. Seven out there, that's Ian Holmes. Lane three coming back, Trevor Perkins. Mansfield now with a sizable lead. Anchor leg for Hopkinton, Brad Canty. Colin Thine now in the water in lane three. Jack Brennan preparing in lane seven. As Brad takes his turn. This should be about a 3:47 for Mansfield. About a unofficial 4:02. What happened to him? Third place. Colin Stein coming in with third place for the Hillers. And finishing up the all-freshman team in lane seven, Jack Brennan. One more swimmer left in the water. And that'll do it for the meet.